battle.
I worry very much about the radiation leak. I don't know what to do.
Very dangerous.
Very dangerous. We are 50 to 60 kilometers away, but we're still a little worried about the radiation leak.
These residents fear for their health as the nuclear crisis at the Fukushima Daiichi power plant worsens. After dealing with a devastating 9-magnitude earthquake and tsunami, the people of Japan face a catastrophe with radiation leaking from the crippled plant. The cooling system of the boiling water reactors, as well as the backup generators and emergency batteries, failed in the tsunami, leading to explosions and fires in the plant. Japan's nuclear crisis sparked a review of nuclear projects in various parts of the globe.
In the light of this situation, we will proceed a security check of all our nuclear plants. The federal government and the state governments agreed about that. Those nuclear plants which started running before the end of the year 1980 will be taken offline, so they will be shut during the period of the moratorium.
Here in the Philippines, critics of the Bataan nuclear power plant cite Japan's crisis as an argument against the revival of the mothballed facility. Former President Cory Aquino scrapped the project on safety concerns and alleged corruption in its construction. 25 years later, critics say health and environmental issues remain unresolved, and an accident may also happen as the Philippines is vulnerable to earthquakes. Malacanang also says this isn't the time to discuss nuclear energy, and it's better to concentrate on less controversial proposals like alternative fuels. Despite Malacanang's statement, Science and Technology Secretary Mario Montejo backs the use of nuclear power. He is also in favor of the use of the Bataan plant, but says it needs retrofitting.
Yes, it is a actually safe economical source of power. We have to pick it in relative terms.
Uh-oh.
Kasi ang taas-taas talaga ng kuryente natin. The only way we can lower it is if we have to use nuclear power. Ang mas mahal pa rin doon yung renewable. We're talking about wind, solar, they are much more expensive.
But the disaster in Japan forced some supporters of nuclear power to rethink their advocacy. Former Pangasinan Representative Mark Cojuangco and his wife Congresswoman Kimmy Cojuangco imposed a moratorium on their efforts to revive the BNPP. But the Cojuangcos still believe nuclear energy is a source of cheap, safe, and reliable power.
BNPP should have given birth by now to 4 or 5 nuclear power plants. We would not have had the take-or-pay contracts. We would not have had to have the IPPs. And I would venture to say that power should be half the price that it is today.
Both advocates and detractors of the Bataan nuclear power plant hope scientists will closely study the Fukushima experience and learn the lessons to ensure nuclear energy will not put lives at risk.
And here to weigh in on this debate, our former Pangasinan Representative Mark Cojuangco has been pushing for the opening and the operation of the Bataan nuclear power plant. And Dr. Giovanni Tapang, convener of the network opposed to the BNPP revival and an associate professor at the UP Diliman National Institute of Physics. We also have Mr. Froilan Tampinco, president of the National Power Corporation. Good evening, gentlemen. Welcome to ANC Presents. Well, Tony, do the honors. Being the tech guy.
not necessarily.
Future perfect.
But let's begin, of course, first with Mr. Tampinco. Right now, you're actually maintaining the BNPP.
Yes, a preservation mode, yes.
Preservation mode. So it's not actually a museum piece when you say it that way, right? Because it's still a fully functional power plant that you can switch on at any point. No?
No, okay. Needs rehabilitation.
All right, so what needs to be done to get it up and running?
Well, firstly, there were certain parts that were already detached from the original operations framework of the plant. So that needs to be put back in place.
Mm-hmm.
the main component, of course, is the fuel, which is no longer there.
No longer there.
And then on the basis of an earlier study that was already done by a Korean group, then they identified a number of equipment that needed to be replaced.
All right.
And also a number of equipment that needed to be refurbished.
And are we talking about equipment that's related to starting the nuclear fission process?
No.
Not necessarily.
They emphasized, though, that in the nuclear part of the plant, it was basically well preserved.
All right. So that's usable without any upgrade.
Yes.
And the parts that you need to bring back would be related to what operation?
The control systems, the more of the ancillary systems that will have to support the basic nuclear reaction that will take place in the core.
Okay, because when we look at the video that we almost always show of the interior of the control room, we know that these are controls that were built back in the 80s.
Oh,
there
yes.
are analog
oh, yes.
switches, analog oh, yes. dials, even a red emergency hotline phone that looks like it came from the Cold War.
Can I make a comment?
Yeah, of course.
Yes, when I visited Gori 2, which is the sister
in Korea.
Identical plant to Bataan, the instrumentation was the same. And the reason why they don't change it is because to change the design is to have the plant recertified, which nobody wants to do. You don't reinvent the wheel. So what happened in Korea is that an industry has emerged that manufactures the circuit boards, original old style but thick tracing circuit boards, heavy duty, and you can buy it brand new.
Great. So you don't necessarily upgrade all the parts, but you still have, you know, 1980 style circuit boards.
Technology, but very robust. Very robust.
So, Mr. Tapinko, what do you upgrade?
The crucial thing there is, if ever there is a decision to repower the Bataan nuclear plant, is where the regulatory body would put itself vis-a-vis the Bataan nuclear plant. Because if it goes and bases its regulatory assessment on present-day regulations, then there will be a lot of things that will have to be put into place.
And to clarify, which regulatory body are you referring to?
Well, here in the Philippines, it has to be the regulatory body that's attached to the PNRI.
The Philippine Nuclear Research Institute.
Yes, but I guess
internationally, do we also have to get it certified?
We have to get the experts to help us out.
From the IAEA.
From the IAEA. And in fact, our own regulatory body usually makes use of the same codes and guidelines.
Okay.
Now, but of course, when we go to the human resource part, they usually get certified by international bodies. Like in the first batch, they were all certified abroad.
Yeah. So for the training of the personnel who will eventually operate the plant. I know Dr. Giovanni Tapang is just itching to get into this discussion. I'll give you just a few seconds to wait. But Congressman Cojuangco, you and Congressman Kimmy Cojuangco now, who's occupying your seat in Congress, both were pushing for the revival of the BNPP, as well as maybe to put up another nuclear plant in your home province in Pangasinan. But now that you've seen what's happening around the world in the aftermath of the Fukushima nuclear crisis, there are other countries more developed than the Philippines who are suspending or rethinking their nuclear energy programs. You've got Spain, Germany, even the U.S. is going to rethink its nuclear rebuilding program. And you also recently said that you want to sort of like step back towards your advocacy for nuclear power.
From actively promoting it at the moment until the reports from Fukushima come in. Credible reports from the agencies concerned, not just from news reports.
And initial thoughts about what's happening and how the Japanese are handling this crisis, what does it tell you?
They're doing the best they can. And you can't really prepare, you can't really react to a crisis, especially in the nuclear plant, if it's not engineered into the plant in the first place. I mean, it's too late to do anything when it's already there.
Okay.
So you prepare by doing the studies of the worst that can happen, and then you build a plant to cope with all those situations, and then you know that when these things happen, then nothing will happen to your plant.
And the way the Japanese are handling it now, do you believe that they actually built it for the worst that could happen, and that they're now doing the best they can?
You preempted me, Tony, because I was going to say. And again, I've pulled back, so I'm only answering this because I'm on your show. I wanted to say that if BNPP were in Fukushima instead of their plants, none of this would have happened. And I can say that because before BNPP was built, a tsunami hit Mindanao.
Right, 76.
And they incorporated design criteria to take care of the tsunami. That's why it's located on a hill.
18 meters above sea level.
18 meters above sea level. 18 plus. No? And Fukushima didn't do that. Secondly, Fukushima was designed to a design spec of 0.18 G. Whereas BNPP is designed to 0.40 G. So